The Attorney General, the former Attorney General Saki Shangala, used to sit on the Judicial Service Commission as set out in Article 85. So how can you tell us we cannot question their processes?
When we've clearly seen...
The former Attorney General is in custody now due to the Fish Road case. So, and now we have requested for transparency. And what did they do? They are saying, no, it will be secretive. How can we not have an issue with that if the person who was arrested was a former Attorney General who served, who was one of your members?
The three shortlisted candidates in the race for the position of the Prosecutor General are Ruth Herunga, a former magistrate, Taswal Julai, chairperson of the Law Society of Namibia, and the former PG, Martha Imalwa, whose term recently ended after serving more than 15 years in office. Activist-in-chief Job Amupanda called out the Judicial Service Commission for not being transparent in the recruitment process of the incumbent PG, adding that the judiciary has allegedly aligned itself with the elite and corrupt leaders in government.
There is a corruption case that involves a lot of millions that were stolen from our country, where a guy from Ivory Coast, who's a friend to some people who are in power, came to our country, swindled government official, entered into some notorious agreements, and he went away with our money. Then there was a court case, the Kora case. Of course, president is mentioned, ministers are mentioned, Saki is mentioned in that case. So when we wanted to follow up on that case, we couldn't access the files. We couldn't access the files because the judiciary have decided that they are going to seal off, they are going to close off this specific case. They are calling it apparently in camera or whatever it is. So the media and everybody else was locked out of that case. So we wrote to the Judicial Service Commission to say, hey, Chief, what is happening here? So do you people take us serious? It's not just because you are a Chief Justice, because we are a judge, hell of a sudden you are Jesus Christ. No. You are given that position of trust in order for us to advance the country forward. So we wrote to them and say, what is going on here? Then all of a sudden, oh no, we are going to investigate. The case is now made public. So we are asking ourselves that if we didn't confront them, if we never wrote to them to open those files, would those files be opened? So those are alarming incidences, our experience with the judiciary, on the basis of facts, not on the basis of speculation, that we see that something is definitely not right with how these things have been operating. There are other incidences of many. As you know, that the judiciary, together with the regime, worked together to create what is called a commercial court. And that commercial court is specifically targeted for and implemented for people with a lot of money. And we had been told that this is not a court that was demanded for by the Namibian people. This is not a court that was introduced as a result of an analysis of problems that we are having with our judiciary. This is a court that was implemented because some foreigners who apparently come to Namibia realize that whenever they have dispute, financial dispute with ever on contracts, they don't want to queue up, just like you and I are queuing up in the normal court system.
The frustration of the AR comes after the Judicial Service Commission excluded the public from the process by deciding to interview the three shortlisted candidates for the PG position in secret. Stanley Kavetu read the demands in the petition and demanded that the Chief Justice Peter Shivute receive it.
That the corrupt process is cancelled and they restart the process. That the secretive Judicial Service Commission embark on a consultative process on the requirements for the position of PG, and that the new process embarked upon is opened up and is transparent, and the interviews are held in public. That's basically the summary of our demands, which we'll submit same to the Judicial Service Commission.
The vacancy for the position of the PG was advertised in September this year, where 8 candidates initially applied for the position, but 5 of these candidates were unsuccessful as they allegedly did not meet the criteria for the position.